Theater in the round, black box theater, anything you can think of, she's done it. And she's also been in New York City, Los Angeles, and Sedona, the hubs of culture and vortexes in this world. Please give it up for Phyllis Boren. Phyllis Boren, everybody. Thank you. Fuck me. Jesus. Well, I guess we've already established I'm not 25. Okay. But in cat years, I'm only 14. And wait, I've got the body of a 40-year-old woman who's in terrible shape. Listen, before I start, I have to tell, I don't think you people are aware how much prejudice there is against older people. Outside, before, when we were parking our car, I heard a woman tell her friend, "Old people have a smell." Well, sure we do. Mine is beer and marijuana. Test question and you're pissed. Oh, and before I start, I'd like to let you know where I'm coming from, okay? I'm on the cusp of sexy black panties and depends. Oh, God. No, it's not so much I'm aging as my infrastructure is wearing out. It's like I signed up for Kundalini yoga. Why? I thought it said cunnilingus yoga. I don't see so well, I don't hear. Here's a, you should have seen their faces when I showed up in my crotchless pants. And then, last month, Lachaim, woo, yay, I put the Jew in there, Jew butter. Okay, last month a friend took me to a la-di-da charity event. Well, I'm so fidgety, so my friend leans over and whispers, "Would you please sit on your hands and stay in your place?" But I thought he said, "Would you please pull down your pants and sit on my face?" So I did. Very codependent. Anyway, but the thing, you know, I'm a little upset tonight. Can you tell? Something I saw the other day just so upset me. Did you ever see an uncircumcised penis? It looks like the Cape Crusader. I didn't know whether to fucking say, "Fuck me or save me." I mean, this is very confusing. You know, but we all come into the world so naive, okay? Right, if you had told me when I was 8 years old that when I grew up I'd have a man's pee-pee in my mouth, when I wouldn't even eat an apple my best friend took a tiny bite out of, I would have hung myself. And girls, this is all these good-looking, very nice-looking girls. Did we know how boring hand jobs were? Guys, do me a favor, leave the TV on! Yes, you know who I'm talking to. I did learn a lot from my Chinese boyfriend in high school, Wao Hong. He was a wonderful student. When he finally located my G-spot, he highlighted it. And before I was married, I was so afraid of commitment, I only bought toilet paper one roll at a time. And now, I've been divorced twice. I've got an ex and a Dos Equis. And my last husband, oh, he was abusive. He'd say things to me like, "Wipe that smile off your face." Well, where else would it be, my ass? And he would say, "Your biggest problem is you always overreact." So I shot him. I have three kids. Well, three kids that I know of. And now I consider myself a postmodern feminist. Guys still pay, but we keep the receipts. Because we're more romantic than men, don't you think so? I mean, they feel their hearts throb, but in their laps, I was watching National Geographic, a program about insects, and I found out the warrior ant, for the privilege of having sex with a female, he dies. Now that's what I call a proper show of gratitude. So guy says to me, who do you think's gonna be in the World Series? What the fuck do I know about sports? I thought the national pastime was masturbation. Okay? My girlfriend's a psychiatrist. She says there's nothing wrong with masturbation. Because it takes off the edge. Sometimes it takes off the skin. But slow. This is the dyslexic section here. I get the jokes. Okay. I was going to masturbate last night, but I had a headache. But according to me, the only thing wrong with masturbation is it's boring. You know, it's kind of like, it's you again. But even in masturbation, there is no equality between the sexes. Now, I mean, what you guys do, you got 100 names for it, right? Jerk it off, jack it off, slap the bunny, peel the pig off, peel the banana. My favorite, punch the clown. Okay. But what, do we have anything? Do we have anything? May I submit this for women? Place finger A on cat B. Visualize that first. Okay, or rotate the rosebud. But my favorite is plugging that one string guitar. Girls back me up here. Oh, girls don't masturbate, do they? Right. This is a masturbation conference. So I hope there's time for me to tell you a brief word about oral sex. More? Okay, thank you very much. Oh, but I was going to say this. Last night, my husband did one of these. I said, what? He said, I have to readjust. My balls are sticking. Guys, is this a big problem? You never heard of tack or pan? You ever wonder if one of the balls is in charge, like the alpha ball? Move over, you're cramping my style. You move over, you're sticking to me. Okay, getting back to oral sex. Girls, if you want to encourage your guys, your partners, to give you oral sex, douche with vodka. I like oral sex, but I look at myself, how long can it last? So I decided to get a tattoo on my labia. Does anybody here not know what a labia is? Tattoo on my labia, it's going to say, best of Eden by 2018. Okay, but I feel a little bit like a hypocrite because I'm not fond of giving it. I once even wrote a protest song about it called Maybe for Your Birthday. Okay, but I'm going to end with a question. This is a savvy crowd. A question for you guys, okay? Why can't you guys make some sounds during sex? Are we supposed to create the whole soundtrack? Couldn't you at least cough? Okay, whistle, crack your knuckles. And when you do come, could you please let us know? A tap on the shoulder? A fax? No, I've got it. A postcard. I've arrived. Having a wonderful time. Wish you were here. Thank you. You've been awesome.
Phyllis, everybody, Phyllis. One more time, give it up, come on.